some of the details of Civic Now, our design, more details on the design changes as well as our market proposition for the car. I'll start off with the packaging for Civic Si, which benefits from all the major changes that we made on the 10th generation Civic. With the new 10th generation Civic, the team really sought to create a compact vehicle that doesn't look or feel like a compact vehicle. So they went for a lower and wider stance to give it a more premium feel and a premium stance. And they also extended the wheelbase of the car to give us more interior volume and also best in class combination of an interior space and luggage space. And this next slide, this gives you the detail on current Civic Si over previous generation car. On the interior, I want to call out the things that really make an Si interior an Si. So we've got one colorway for the interior. The baseline color theme is black with carbon accents laid into the seats and into the interior dash panel. We've got red accent stitching throughout on the seats. We've got the red Si badges embossed on the seats as well. Shifter knob contrast stitching on the steering wheel as well as the door panels. And we've also got red illumination which is the default for the center stack, as well as in the instrument mirror. And we've got sport aluminum pedals, which are standard on Si as well. So those seats not only look good, but they are very functional and very comfortable. And the bolsters in the seat, they're not just cosmetic padding. They actually made a unique seat frame for the Civic Si. So you can see there's actual additional bolster metal wire frame supporting all those bolsters that help keep you in your hips in place and the seat cushion and your upper body supported as well in let's say high lateral G conditions. Other cool thing about the Civic Si, we added some additional features in the meter. So again, when you go in between sport mode and normal mode, the center cluster changes from a cool blue. You'll see it turn red and notify that you're in sport mode. You get a sport mode icon up there. Hopefully all you guys were in sport mode out on the track. I think when you get out today onto the road, you can kind of toggle in between the two to see what it feels like. There are some unique displays in the gauge. Some of these are on the standard Civic, but we added a few more in for Civic Si. So for Si, we've got throttle and brake application display. We've got the turbo boost display. We've got the rev indicator, which I think is probably what was defaulted on most of your cars when you drove today. We also have a G meter and a lap timer. So feel free to play around with those when you're out on the road. Just also keep your eyes on the road, please. Okay, so really the foundation of any good performance car is a solid platform, right? So 10th generation Civic was created with Civic Si in mind, as well as Type R in mind. And the team, of course, sought to make it stronger and lighter. So this generation of Civic is 25% more rigid, torsionally and torsional rigidity. All the while, we've actually made this Si 100 pounds lighter than the previous generation car. And that translates not only within the Honda lineup from previous generation to current generation, but it's also significantly lighter than all the competition, more than 100 pounds lighter than any of its competitors shown here. So strong and light, solid platform. On top of that, the new 1.5 turbo, which you've seen in previous generation car, this is the stoutest version of the 1.5 turbo we have on offer now. It's got a larger turbocharger with increased boost pressure. With that, we deliver peak horsepower, 205 horsepower at 5,700 RPMs. That comes on 1,300 RPMs earlier than the previous generation car. Also, we've got more torque on this car than the standard 1.5 turbo, and it's also significantly more than the previous generation car. So the driving character of this, we sought to basically enhance the mid-range power of this car and create more fun to drive for customers. And sort of a consequence of the 1.5 turbo, although this wasn't a specific target for Si customers, is we've also got best-in-class fuel economy in the sport compact segment. Okay, 6-speed manual transmission. Differences between this shifter and the one in the standard manual transmission Civic is it's a shorter shifter, We shortened up the stroke by 10%, increased the rigidity. There's a stronger mounting bracket on there, so when you guys are banging the shifter around, you want to keep it in the car. So, feel free to row the gears to your heart's content. And also standard on every Civic Si is a helical limited slip differential. Okay. Some of the chassis changes. So this generation of Civic Si, we've got 18-inch wheels, 18-inch tires, 235 series, 235 width, 40 series tires. The width is up 10 millimeters over the previous generation car. Also all new for Civic Si is the adaptive damper system. We've upsized the brakes over the standard EX turbo cars. It's up 1.2 inches. The rotors are up 1.2 inches in the front and 0.9 inches in the rear. Also, we've got the dual pinion variable ratio front steering. We've actually sized up the motor in a rack to deal with the larger wheel and tire package on the car and the aggressive driving that we expect our customers to put into this car. Okay, here's some details. We're gonna geek out a little bit on on specs on suspension because some of you guys are interested in this. So I've got some extra detail here. So the main thing is for SI over standard car, basically stiffened up the mounting points. We got stiffer spring rates, stiffer stabilizer bar, stiffer compliance cushions. You've heard before when we talked about previous 10th generation Civic, we've got fluid filled bushings for ride comfort and compliance. We've actually got solid type on this car to actually stiffen up the road, make it more responsive. We've actually got some common bits here, which you'll also in the rear suspension, which we adapted from the new Type R. So the upper rear control arm is also from Type R, also stiffened up. So what you're hearing is for performance, we basically strengthened and stiffened everything up. But the offset to that is we can do all that without making the customer suffer because we've got an adaptive damping suspension. So it really works out well. Okay. So I want to take you through a little bit of detail on the settings. And so we're with this generation of SI, first time we're introducing a two-mode drive system. So the default mode for the car is normal, and when you turn the car on, and then you can add it, pressing the button near the shifter. Sport mode, you'll see the meter indicate that you've switched modes, and what that affects is the adaptive damper system. It affects the electric power steering settings, it affects the drive-by-wire throttle response, and it also affects the VSA thresholds. So I'm going to take you through some details on how each one of those are affected, but the main point of this was to be able to create a car that you can drive every day. You know, if you want to commute in the car, you just want to chill out and have a comfortable ride, we've got normal mode, and if you're really looking forward to driving, you want to get on a winding road and have a sporty experience, we can amp it up in the sport character. So the two-mode, the damper system actually has two settings. So when you hit sport, it's a solenoid valve, controlled proportioning valve in the shock absorbers. And basically when you press that button, it adjusts the orifice opening for the proportioning valve and basically stiffens up the damper. So this graph basically illustrates both compression and rebound damping on the shocks. So in normal mode, you've got full range. When you go into sport mode, you can see the minimum damping force is that level is raised. So you've got a stiffer response, but you still do have an adaptive range on that car in that setting as well. Okay, on the dual pinion EPS. So if you guys hadn't heard the talk on dual pinion before, so the point of this is this setup for dual pinion power steering is to give you better steering feel. On top of that, we've got a variable ratio rack to basically make the steering more responsive. And then as I mentioned, when you go into sport mode, basically it stiffens up the response on the steering. So it doesn't change the ratio, but you'll have it'll change the assist level, so that it just helps you get more feel out of the electric power steering as well. Okay. On top of that, drive-by-wire throttle, so we change the throttle progression depending on whether you're in normal or sport mode. You can see basically with same throttle tip-in, you've got more response in sport mode, And if you take the point from that graph on the left side and you look over the right side, you can see that basically with the same throttle opening, you're experiencing more acceleration, more acceleration G in the sport mode, which is the action that we were going for. Okay, let's talk about aerodynamics. So there's some very subtle differences in the aerodynamics on the SI versus the standard car. But you've got a chin spoiler on the front end of the car. You've got that cool-looking rear deck wing spoiler. They do add some function basically to lower the coefficient of lift on the car in the front end and the rear end. On top of that, over the previous generation car, the team thought, even though they wanted to go for this really cool, aggressive bumper design, but it's still coefficient of drag on the car with this new design is 5% improved over the previous generation car. So it looks cool and that has very aerodynamic. Okay, the exhaust system. So the layout of the exhaust system also unique for SI. You've seen the center exhaust on the Sport as well. This one's got some enhancements to it. So we got the big center pipe going down the middle. We split out to two mufflers in the back, so dual silencers, and then bring them back together for the center outlet exhaust. This system is 23% more flow capacity than the standard 1.5 turbo system. And the team tuned the sound so that we get a more aggressive mid-range sound. But on the top end, they tried to tune out some of the higher level noise so you get a more refined ride when you're like flying down the highway. You don't need to listen to it all the time. But even though with this type of layout, we do get more flow out of the car based on the size of the silencers. Okay? All right, for the dynamic performance, this is a radar chart, or you know, could be a spider chart if we spun it around, but it might be really hard to look at. So the baseline there in the center line, the white line down the left side is the previous generation SI. Black line is current EX Turbo Civic. The red line is the blue line is the new Civic SI in normal mode, and the red line is the Civic SI in sport mode. And so we hope that you can see from this, and also that you experience it on the track, that the team really sought to improve, you know, handling, stability, balance, NVH, everything. They went into this new car to make it a more performance-oriented car without the sacrifices of comfort and that you typically experience in making a high-performance version of your vehicle.